Good morning, dear friends. In last class, we have discussed chapter 11. The name of chapter 11 is force and pressure. In last class, I have told you what is force, what is the characteristic of force, how an object can change their shape and size when we apply force. So in today's class, we will discuss change in the shape and size of an object when we apply the force. Okay, and we can also calculate the force when we applied of an object. Then what is the formula of force if we applied on an object? The formula is F equals to M. F represent the force, M is a mass, A is acceleration. Acceleration means change in velocity at a time. Change in velocity at a time of an object is known as acceleration. So the force is multiplication of mass and acceleration. So with the help of this formula, we can calculate the force of an object. The SI unit means standard international unit of force is Newton. Newton is the unit of force which is represented by N. Okay, this is the formula of force. With the help of this formula, we can calculate the force. Now we will discuss how the change shape and size of object. First, we will discuss force can change the state of an object. How force can change the state? When we can say if an object is said to be in motion. If an object is said to be in motion means object can move from one place to another place. It means changing speed in a particular direction. Changing speed, it's moving by a certain speed in a particular direction. Means if an object can move, means this object move with a certain speed in a particular direction. Okay, if object is not moving, means object in a rest condition, means there is no change in position, means there is a no speed. Without speed, without any speed, means speed if zero, then your object is in rest condition, it cannot move. When object start moving, it means that its position is being changed. Means a object start moving. For example, I start moving. Means my position is changes. My state is changes. When the state is changes, I am going from one place to another place. Okay, an object is going from one place to another place. It means a force is applied. When a force is applied on an object, the state of object is changed. Without apply any force, the state of an object doesn't change. For example, this is a car. This is a car. It is in rest condition. Means there is no speed. Speed is zero. When speed is zero, this car cannot move. When this car is moved, then it is move in a particular direction. Move in a particular direction with particular speed. If any object moves in a particular direction, then it contains a particular speed. Without speed, it cannot move in a particular direction. If we apply the force on this car, if we apply the force in this car, then this car can move in right direction. Then this car can move in right direction. So, if we change the direction of any object from one place to another place, we can change the state and we can also change the direction. So, we must apply the force. Without force, we cannot change the direction, we cannot change the state of any object. So, force can change the speed, force can change the speed and even change the direction. Without force, speed and direction cannot change. Hence, we can say force can change the state of an object. Force can change the state of an object. An object cannot move without application of any force. If we cannot apply any force, the object cannot change their state. Okay? For example, but it is not necessary every time the state of an object will be changed. It is not possible every time. For example, if I want to push this wall, I want to push this wall. This is wall and I want to push this wall. Then I have applied many force, but I cannot push this wall. So it is not necessary every time if we apply a force, then state can be changed. It not possible every time. For example, wall. If we apply the force on the wall, then we cannot push the wall. So it is not possible every time. Okay. So with the help of force, we can change the state, speed, even direction of an object. Now, force also changes the shape of an object. For example, if we talk about a sponge, then if we apply the force, then shape of sponge change. If we talk about the spring, from this shape, if we apply the force, then shape of spring will be changed. For example, if we take a paper, if we apply the force, then shape of paper is changed. So force can change the shape of an object. So with the help of force, we can change the state, we can change the shape of an object. Okay. Now this is with the help of force, we can change the state and shape of an object. Now we will discuss the type of an force. How many type of force? There are two type of force. First one is contact force and second one is non-contact force. Contact force means two objects interact to each other. Then contact force is applied. When two objects interact to each other, then contact force is applied. For example, muscular force. Air resistance force. Frictional force. This is the example of contact force when two objects contact to each other. Non-contact force, when two objects cannot interact to each other. Then non-contact force is applied. Non-contact force is many types. For example, gravitational force, electrostatic force. This is the example of non-contact force. The force also of two type, contact and non-contact force. In next class, we will discuss different type of forces, muscular force, frictional force, electrostatic force, gravitational force. Okay. Thank you so much.